Congressman Emanuel Cleaver is a Democrat from Missouri, and Joan Walsh is an MSNBC political analyst and editor-at-large at Salon. Congressman, I've been listening to you lately, and I think you got a lot to say about this, but I am dumbfounded at the utter incompetence of our government. Coming at this thing in a crisis mode for 3 weeks, everyone in America caring about those kids one way or the other, and nothing. Looks like the Congress is going to lead with nothing done.
Well, they're talking about trying to stay overnight and do something tomorrow morning, but even that, Chris, is absolutely nothing. This is insulting to the people of this country. It's insulting to people who are in Washington because we thought we were here to solve problems. And I'm not a name caller, a bomb thrower, but I can tell you I'm sick and tired of what's going on here in Congress because there's nothing going on. And, you know, there are people who it seems have come to Washington for the sole purpose of disrupting the government. They are anti-government. And the people out in the country are the ones who are going to have to stop this.
Well, who wins when Ted Cruz, the senator from Texas, the firebrand of all firebrands, he come over and meets with a dozen of your Republican colleagues. Next thing you know, Boehner, the supposed speaker, at least the nominal speaker of the House, finds he doesn't have a majority to do anything. What's going on where a senator can, there he is, walking across the Capitol or whatever, and just jamming everything up?
Well, you know, in some ways, it troubles me deeply to believe that one human being can disrupt the compassion of a nation of 300 million people. In a real sense, that troubles me deeply. But I know that there are some people who, under normal circumstances, are good and decent people. But they come around here with people who hate the government, and they are different. They don't get ulcers. They are carriers. And that's what's going on up here. We have a lot of carriers of people who come in and get the whole body of politics sick. And we are sick right now, maybe sick unto death.
Is there a fear in the Republican caucus that any time there's a line drawn, for example, are you for suing the president or not, you have to always be on the right side of that, the right-wing side of that?
Well, I mean, what people won't say, and Nancy Pelosi, I've got to give her a lot of credit. I mean, she continues to remind people that that was a question that the media dropped on her repeatedly during her speakership. And she always said, impeachment is not on the table. No matter how many weapons of mass destruction were not found, that's not going to be impeachment. Speaker Boehner won't do that.
Yeah, he won't. He doesn't want to offend anybody. He won't even say that birtherism is wrong. Remember he said a while back, I don't want to tell people how to think. I want to go to Joan on this for a second. I'll be right back to you, Congressman. Joan, we've been watching politics a lot, me longer than you. I've never seen such failure and such fear. They won't help those kids. They won't give them a nickel. As I said, one Lincoln-headed penny.
Not one Lincoln-headed
Nothing.
Penny.
Nothing. Your thought.
No, it's tragic, Chris. And, you know, the congressman is right. There are some carriers of a real sickness. And, you know, Ted Cruz is doing his best to spread it. But Bill Kristol laid it out this morning in the Weekly Standard. I got to give him credit. He basically told the House GOP, kill this bill because we don't want to see you do the heavy lifting of governing. We don't want you back in your districts having to defend something you did or didn't do. We want to drop this on the president. We want the finger of blame pointing at one man, President Obama, and we don't want you to get your hands dirty with compromise, with actually thinking about the complicated set of reasons that this problem wound up at our border. You can't do that. We don't want you implicated in governing. And when
That's
you have
called
one
scorched
party,
earth.
It's scorched
That's when you burn
earth.
Your
sabotage.
Own field so the enemy won't eat.
It is sabotage dressed up as political genius. And it's not just Ted Cruz, it's a lot of people. But Ted Cruz is the symbol. He is one man out for himself. There is no principle in this. You know, he wants them to cut the funding for the deferring the deportations. It's not funded by Congress. These applications, it's a self-funded program by application fees. They can't even cut the money. What he's trying to do can't really even be done, but that doesn't matter. What matters is grinding up the gears of government and making people believe that we can't do anything as a country, and it's very sad.
Anyway, it's August vacation time. It looks like Congress is going to leave and not get this done. Oh, there's a last gas chance tomorrow. Let me look at this. Congressman, look at this comment by the governor of Texas. Anger and outrage has already begun to pour in from some members of the Republican Party. After the House pulled the border bill today, Texas Governor Rick Perry, of all people, issued this statement. It's beyond belief that Congress is abandoning its post while our border crisis continues to create humanitarian suffering. And criminal aliens still represent a clear threat to our citizens and our nation. Congress should not not go into recess until the job is completed. What's your bet right now, Congressman Sauer? Do you think that the Republicans are going to scatter back tomorrow, have a quickie, and pass it? And will it go anywhere in the Senate? Will we get anything to the president's desk?
I doubt it. They don't have the votes right now, and so they're going to beat people up all night long and hope to have them tomorrow morning. And even then, it's going to be questionable. And if something comes across, it's going to be watered down from what it is now, trying to accommodate the far right in the Republican conference. And so when it gets over to Senator Reid and a more sensible Senate, I don't think it's going to go anywhere, which ought to make Americans so angry that they begin to react to all of these people who come to Washington to disrupt the nation. It is sick, and I'm sick of it, and I hope the people around the country are sick of it, and that they'll come out and express their sickness in November.
Well, let me ask you about this, and I'll go to Joan on this, too. You know, back in 1948, I love history like you all do, too, and I was thinking, you know, Harry Truman had a do-nothing Congress back after World War II. They did nothing except investigate people for communism, and maybe they caught a communist here or there, but basically they're wasting time. They used to open with a prayer and end with a probe, as somebody once said. It was all wasting time and investigations. It was Darrell Issa right across the floor. Now, my question is, do you think the American people are going to vote for nothing, a party that stands for nothing, Congressman? Because that's what the Republicans are saying. Like us, we'll do nothing.
My fear is that people don't realize that there's only one human being who can actually bring a measure to the floor in the House of Representatives, and it is the Speaker. And I appreciate what the governor of Texas is saying. That sounds like something I could have said. The problem is he needs to, instead of saying Congress, he ought to say the Republicans in Congress and call names, because my fear is that the American public doesn't understand the nuances, and they may not understand that it is the Republicans, not the Congress, it's the Republicans.
Well, the border bill in the House, by the way, Joan, responded to this, was reworked four times, you know, to appease the red hots, and it still failed. Here's the timeline. July 8th, President Obama asked Congress for $3.7 billion to address the crisis on the border, all those young kids down there. The House does nothing until July 23rd. Then they began putting together a $1.5 billion counteroffer. 3 days after that, the package is scaled down to $1 billion. On July 29th, it shrunk to $659 million. Last night, Ted Cruz began whipping support against it. So this morning, the Speaker announced a package to attract their support by attaching a plan to block the president's power to halt deportations of certain groups of immigrant children. And this afternoon, still without enough support, the Speaker pulled the bill from the floor. Joan, he tried to appeal. He tried to pander to the hard right. It didn't work because, as Congressman Cleaver just said, they don't want to be appeased. They want to be able to go home and say, we don't have our hands on this thing.
No, exactly. And if you read that statement that the Speaker's office released, Chris, where he says the president can take actions on his own without Congress, that's what they're suing him for. That's what some of them want to impeach him for. They're saying he does too much through executive action, and now they're saying, well, he can handle this problem through executive action. It is crazy. It is a setup. And I know some of my friends in the mainstream media want to go on and on about how it's the left and Democrats that are talking about impeachment. Certainly we didn't start it. I don't know that we're going to be the ones who get to finish it either. This is designed to make this man, to depict this man, our president, as a tyrant and a dictator who's usurping power, and they're now telling him to do it. And then next week they'll be telling us they're going to impeach him over it.
Thank you so much for joining us, Congressman. By the way, sorry for mispronouncing your name. I was thinking of Emanuel Sauer, who was around this place for 1,000 years.
You are far more
lively and more alive than that gentleman. Thank you for joining us.